Today, Sheridan College in Oakville, Ontario produces scores of world-class animators for Canadian companies and, of course, for Disney.
Nick Ranieri is a Sheridan graduate and one of the top animators at Disney here in Los Angeles. He created such characters as Jafar in Aladdin and Lumiere the Candlestick in Beauty and the Beast. We've dropped by to his LA mansion to talk with him about animation.
Hello?
Nick, it's Rick Green.
Who?
From History Bites.
Who?
In Canada.
Who?
The show we were doing an interview about animation today.
Okay. Go ahead.
It's still closed.
No, I mean, go ahead with the first question.
So, Nick, tell me why you made the decision to work in the United States and what that move has meant for you.
Well, Walter, that's a very interesting question with a very interesting, fairly complex, and somewhat shocking answer.
Uh-huh.
Unfortunately, I'm kind of busy right now, you know, with what, you know, being rich and successful and very busy and all, and so that's really all I can tell you.
Okay, well, thanks so much. Thanks for talking with us, buddy. Take care, Nick. But not all of our animators have gone south. Bryce Hallett is another Sheridan graduate who stayed in Canada. Let's talk to him about his success. Bryce.
Yes?
It's Rick Green.
Oh, hey, Rick.
I wanted to talk to you for a sec about animators like yourself who stayed in Canada and made it big.
Oh, fantastic. I think it's so important to discuss these issues. I'll be right down.
Bryce is a class guy, and I...
Hi, Rick. I can't talk very long, but my shift ends at 6. I'll answer your questions if you buy me a coffee.
Yeah, sure.
Thanks. Oh, and a donut. I'd really love a donut.
Thanks so much.
No problem.
Oh,
so in 1912, Raoul Barre, he's this French-Canadian, he was a cartoonist and a painter. He created like the pig bar system, which is like these little perforations here so you can get registered, which meant you could draw backgrounds in one layer and you can draw characters in another instead of having to draw every single frame. Could you imagine drawing every single frame of a Disney movie? That's like thousands and thousands of drawings, which would be crazy. So thanks to him, we don't have to do that. Then nothing really happens in Canada though, because Americans own all our theater chains and they don't want competition. But 1939, they create the NFB.
Right.
And they bring in Norman McLaren. Norman McLaren, hugely influential to all these animators, even to Walt Disney, but not voted the greatest Canadian. Can you imagine that? So then Nelvana comes up, and they start working on a film with Rock and Roll, which kind of has these rat-like guys. It was really cool looking. It wasn't the greatest film, though, but it trained all these animators. They do like these little shorts, like Cosmic Christmas and Romeo and Juliet with like the robots. They even did this short cartoon for the Star Wars Christmas special. That thing is totally unwatchable, but it's just really cool. It's like you see Boba Fett before Empire Strikes Back even comes out, which is like, you know, Geek City. But
as Bryce pointed out, eventually, Canada has become a world leader in animation. Companies like Nelvana, Cinar, and Decode produce dozens of cartoon shows for kids and adults. As I said to Bryce when he took a breath, Canada excels in niche television like skit comedy, documentaries, news programs. And Bryce said, oh, and don't forget animation.